Hello everyone, good morning. So today we are going to start our new subject, that is railways, bridges and tunnels. Myself Pramjot Singh, I will be your lecturer this semester for this course of RBT. We'll start with chapter number one, that's introduction. So what is there are basically three portions of this subject, that is railways, bridges and tunnels. These are three different fields, you can say. So we are first focusing our main focus is on railways first, because this is a major portion or part of your syllabus, as well as in civil engineering it has main importance too. So let's start with introduction to railways engineering. What is railway engineering? It is the branch of the civil engineering which deals with the construction, design and maintenance of railway track for the safe and efficient movement of trains is called railway engineering. Civil engineering the oh sub branch ya sub discipline jide vich ki assi railway tracks nu design kivein kita janda, construct kivein kita janda, ohdi maintenance kivein kiti jandi hai, वो सारा कुछ पढ़ांगे ता जो सारिया ट्रेन की प्रॉपर ईजी मूवमेंट हो जाए, एफिशिएंट मूवमेंट हो जाए, दैट इज कॉल्ड रेलवे इंजीनियरिंग. नाउ व्हाट इज द स्कोप ऑफ रेलवे इंजीनियरिंग? रेलवे इंजीनियरिंग पढ़न दा या कितने असी यूज करते, जिमें टाइप्स ऑफ सर्वेज, रेलवे ट्रैक्स कितों उच्चे होने चाहिए, कितों नीवा होना चाहिए, रेलवे किधर नू कर्व जानी है, उहदे लई जिन्ने भी सर्वेज ने उदे विच रेलवे इंजीनियरिंग दा काम आंदा. मटीरियल्स रेलवे ट्रैक दे विच केड़े केड़े यूज होंदे ने, जिवें बैलास्ट हो गया, कंकर हो गए, सॉयल होगी, मूरम होगी, काफ़ी सारे मटीरियल्स ने जिहड़े एज ए सब ग्रेड या एज ए सब बैलास्ट या बैलास्ट यूज किए जाते हैं. नैक्सट ट्रैक जोमैट्रिक्स, वट इज कर्व, वट इज द एंगल ऑफ द कर्व, राइट, वट इज द डिग्री ऑफ द कर्व, what is super elevation, how high the super elevation should be. So everything comes under the point of track geometrics. We'll definitely going to design, when we are going to design, which is not in your syllabus but in BTech course, so they are going to design the track, then they need very much then they have to use track geometrics at that time. So that's of very high importance, but not right now of yours use because of your syllabus restrictions. Next is points and crossings, railway stations and yards, signaling, how signals are, interlockings are there. So we'll study everything. These all, you can say these are a type of name of your chapters which are going to study in railway engineering. Now, what is the necessity of railways? As we know that railway is a mean that which provide convenient and safe means of transporting people and goods over large distances and over large volumes in the country. Railways help in uniting the people of different religions, customs, traditions, different parts of the country, and thus strengthen national unity. Railways help in developing cultural and social ties. It helps in growth of trade and industrial apni country nu industrial point of view to the trade point of view to upar chakkan de liye vi railways da bahut vadda hath hai, kyunki ayat koi kito baro samaan leke aana te itho bhejna, that everything kuch portion of the railways de through kita janda. Railways to sade sarkar nu revenue milda hai, better law and order maintain hunda ya. Railways national defense de vich vi sanu help kardi hai, not directly but indirectly. How indirectly? That it agar tusi war days de vich ikko dam bahut sari sena leke jani hai, then you can't use that much of, you know, bikes, cars or trucks. You have to use such transport which can take so many people at a single time. So railways is the cheapest and best. Right, we have helicopters, we have aeroplanes, but the cheapest and best method obviously is railways. So railways help in growth of trade and industrial development in a country. It helps in price stabilization of commodity. If the some place is very mobile means it is very far away from us, where the things which are not approachable easily. So railways can help them. Railways can help them to for the approaching of that materials which they want, or you can say what the good they want, without the charges of the travelization, because railways in the all over the country, right? It is the railway track is spread over the every area of our India, approximately every area. Not obviously it is not, you know, right to say that it is 100% true, but 95% railways are there, so they can just maintain the price stabilization to the mobile areas residents. So there are the zones of railway administrations. Railway has basically these 9 subcategories, which are Eastern Railway, Southeastern Railway, Northern Railway, Northeastern Railway, Southern Railway, Central Railway, Western Railway, Northeast Frontier Railway, South Central Railway. These are the zones. In 2 marks questions, sometimes these questions may be asked that what are the zones of railway administrations, right? The main is the central railways. Next is what are the systems of the railways? There are basically 4 systems: surface, elevated, underground, and tube. Surface railways da matlab jehdiyan railways ya jehdiyan trains assi simple tang de naal keh liye, jehdiyan trains surface de upar travel kardiyan ya earth de ground level de upar, then that are called surface railways. What are elevated railways? Elevated railways matlab jede railways bridges de upar transfer hunde, jehdiyan rails bridges de utte trains aa jehdiyan bridge de upar lang rahiyan ne, theek hai ji, ground level to bahut uchiyan chukiyan gaiyan ne, that railways are called elevated railways, the railways which are provided at higher position above the ground surface. Third is underground. Underground and tube railways are same, which are below the ground level, but the only difference is underground railways te tube railways de vich difference ki hai. Jehdiyan tube railways aa jadon ground level to thalle jehdi depth hai 18 meter to vadh jave, 18 meter to leke 52 meter de vich hove, from 18 meters to 52 meters the depth, if the tube railways are provided there, if the railways are provided there, then these are called tube railways, unless or otherwise they are called underground railways when the depth is below 18 meters. But obviously it should below ground level and above the up to the 18 meters, right? These are the railways provided over ground surface or surface railways. The system are most extensively used in the world. This is the best system because goods are easy to transport here and there in surface railways. Elevated railways, when it is provided at higher elevation, these are also called high level railways. These are suitable when there are highly congested areas, matlab the people living in the per square meter, you know, that population density is very much. So at that places, elevated railways are suitable. Underground railways, these are called also called low level railways. These are basically used when we have to, these are not, you can say it is a necessity, but it is something which we should take care of, that if we want sometime, or you can say for future expansions, or for from any point of view, if we want that we want an a railways or a path or a mode of transport in which there should be no obstructions should be there, right, then these railways are used, underground railways. These help in reducing traffic congestion problems. It is the very point, good point. It's third point. This system provides safety against during aerial attack in war. Then at that time, these are proved to be very good at that time, but not in general locations. So these are suitable in heavily congested areas where traffic intensity of roads is heavy. tube railways, when the railways provided underground at a depth of about 18 meters to 52 meters are called tube railways, right? That obviously tube railways, these are, I think, clarified from the word that the railways, the path of the train from which train moves is a circular path. It is in the form of a cylinder. Escalators or moving staircases are to be constructed to reach the tube railways. Using only electric traction method is used to run the train, because if you will go for smoke or ventilation problems will be there if you go for simple railways. Automatic signaling system to be used for that, right? So these are the four type of railways which are mostly broadly classified. So the very best we can say is surface railways, because it is very approachable to all of the people without any problem, right? The goods can be transported very easily. If there is any problem in railway track, or they can be easily altered. So these are the some of the advantages of surface railways. So in next video lecture, we'll move on to next chapter. This is the completion of the chapter number 1, that is introduction. Thank you.